thank God for you being with us this morning. We are expecting. We know that God is here, and no matter where we are, you at your home, wherever you are, God is with you, and we're going to offer up a sacrifice of praise. I welcome you for being with us. I am here, the senior pastor of this house, Pastor Isaac, who will be ministering. We just welcome you, and we thank you for being a part of what we're doing today. Amen. And we're going to ask that you will share it, okay? Share it on your page. We want to spread God's love, praise and worship, and the word as far as we can spread it. Amen. Especially during this time. So we want you to be blessed, but we want you to participate in praise and worship. Amen. Thank you once again. And we're going to go ahead and get started. Are you ready to offer up a sacrifice of praise? Amen. Amen. I'll bring before you our praise team, New Life in the City worship team. Enjoy and praise and worship God. Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, wherever you are in your house, come on, just lift up your voice and lift up your hands. Come on, because he's worthy to be praised. Come on, if you know that he's worthy to be praised, feel free to sing along with us. Feel free to worship with us, because there is no one like our God. And right now, God, you deserve the glory. Come on, I remember David said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continue to be in my mouth. So no matter what's going on in the world, I will bless the Lord. Not sometimes, but all times, Lord God. I will bless your holy name. I will bless your holy name. Somebody bless the Lord with me. Come on, somebody bless the Lord with me. Because it's worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, my God is worthy. Say, my God is worthy. Say, my God is worthy.
Somebody belongs to you. My hallelujah all goes to you, God. My hallelujah belongs to you. It's worthy of our best, oh God. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody just lift up your voice.
Glory, glory.
Come on, somebody just lift up your voice. Because he's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our praise, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yeah.
come before your presence. We are honored, Lord God, that we know your name. We are honored this morning, oh God, that we can call upon you at any time, oh Lord God, and oh Lord God, from any place, Lord God. And Father God, we thank you, Lord God, that your name is Jehovah Shammah, oh Lord God. And Father God, you are wherever we are today, Lord God. This morning, oh God, we came for a word from you.
My God.
We came for a word from you.
Yes.
We want a word from you, oh God.
Yes.
So this morning, oh God. Father God, in the midst of this, Lord God, what's happening in our society and around the world, Lord God, you continue to sustain us.
Yes.
So we want to eat from your table. Anoint my lips this morning, oh God.
Yes.
Use me this morning, oh Lord God, as your mouthpiece, that in hearing we may receive the word that's able to save our souls.
Yes.
If your word can save our souls, surely, oh God, it can save us, oh Lord God, from this pandemic. If your word can save our souls, Lord God, then surely, oh Lord God, it can heal us, Lord God.
Yes.
If your word, oh God, can save our souls, then surely this morning, oh God. Father God, we look to you.
Yes, we do.
In the precious and mighty name of Jesus, we pray. And we all say, Amen. God bless you this morning. We want to thank you for being right here with us, for inviting us into your living room.
Bye-bye.
And I thank God for this opportunity to come before you. Good morning. My name is Pastor Isaac. I'm with New Life in the city. And we have a word for you this morning. Our topic for this morning is God hears your cry. God hears your cry. Those of you all that are home, in the comforts of your living room, in your office, wherever you may be, in your car, listening, amen. I pray that you have your Bible. It's time to go to church.
Yeah. Amen.
To go to church. I pray you were blessed by the praise and worship. I love our praise team.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Several months ago, the coronavirus pandemic started in China, spreading to Italy, and making its way around the world to our community. I know that many lives are being impacted. I know that this morning that our livelihoods are being impacted, that our children are being impacted. Our world is quickly changing from week to week, even day to day. But this morning, I'm here to remind you that the human coronavirus, it's not a God.
Amen.
It's not a God.
Amen.
The reason that they call this COVID-19 is because there was a COVID-18 and a COVID-17 and a COVID-16. But I'm here to tell somebody that there is only one God.
My
Say
God.
Only one God.
Only one God.
Amen. He is Alpha and Omega. He's the first and the last. He is the beginning and the end. The name of God is above all names. I'm going to say that one more time. The name of God is above all names.
Amen.
Amen.
The name, oh, I just love that song. The name
of God.
It's above every other name.
Yes.
In Proverbs, those of you all that's following, Proverbs, 18:10, it says, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and is safe. The name, just the name. Y'all know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Sometimes when you're about to have that near miss and you just say, Jesus.
Yes.
You see that thing is about to happen to your loved one and you can't get there fast enough. And you say, Jesus.
Ooh.
That name is above all names.
Yes.
Huh? We find safety in that name, Jesus. We find peace in that name, Jesus.
Yes.
Huh? Is there somebody that's willing to say, Jesus?
Jesus.
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 Oh yeah, he hears your cry. And he knows just what you mean when you say Jesus. Amen. I want you to know this morning that right now, as we're in this and that right now that we're in the midst of this pandemic, I'm here to tell you that faith and fear cannot coexist. Amen. As a matter of fact, faith and fear are two polar opposites of each other.
Yes.
The Bible says in Hebrews, the 10th chapter and the 38th verse, that the just, most of us, we know it. It says the just shall live by faith. But, yes. But I want you to know that the way that it reads in the Bible, it says now. It starts off with now. Now.
Yes.
The just. Say the just.
The just.
See, that's you. Say the just.
The just
shall live by faith.
Yes.
Oh yeah, it says now the just shall live by faith. And I want you to know that this is that time, this is that season when the just shall live by faith. And if you notice, one of the things that this pandemic does is that it divides us. This pandemic, it divides us. But if by chance you find yourself quarantined, if by chance you find yourself being in your house all alone, you find yourself, you got to live by your faith.
Yes.
Not mama's faith, not your brother's faith, not your husband's faith. They can pray for you, but there comes a time when you have to stand on your faith. Amen? Say my faith.
My faith.
Yeah, you have to stand on your faith. You have to stand on your faith. And this morning, I'm here to remind you of the song. And I love the song. The song is Solid Rock by Edward Moe. He's the writer. And he says, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. Oh, God is so good. God is so good this morning. Again, for those of you all that's just joining us, our topic for this morning is God hears your cry. God hears your cry. And I know that you all are adults. And I know that you are, adults. And I know that this morning that you say, well, Pastor, cry. Well, let's put it in, I want to give you a similarity this morning. If you've been blessed with having children, infants have different types of cries. There's a cry that says, I'm hungry. There's a cry that says, I'm thirsty. There's another cry that says, I need to be changed. Can somebody change me? Get this thing off of me.
Yeah.
And as parents and caretakers, we learn to recognize those cries. I'm going to share this with you all. I just had this little thing that I would do. I would run. See, my wife, she was, I thank God for her. She's a great mother. We've been married for 29 years, and I thank God. I truly, truly thank God for my wife. But I remember during the early years of us as parents, and so what I would do when the child cries, I would come and I would just, there are certain things that I would check for. I had this thing in my family, you know, and I would do a pitch test.
Yeah.
You know, are you wet? Then I check the diaper. Do you need to be changed? And sometimes, do you know that all the child wants you to do is pick them up?
That's it.
Sometimes all they want is affection. And there are times, do you know, dads, fathers, godfathers, grandfathers, don't take this wrong, but there are times, do you know that all they want is mommy? All they want is mommy. Because they know mommy's smell. Do you know that as an infant, your child can tell the difference between their mommy and any other mom? But this morning, I want you to know something. That just as parents, when we can recognize and we can discern, watch this now, we can recognize and discern the different types of cries.
It's okay.
What about God?
Come on now.
So my those of you all that know me, you know that I have a grandson, and my grandson, he has a certain cry. It's not really a cry, but kind of like a growl. And so my wife and I, we call it the sleepy growl. There are times that even when he wants to fall asleep, yes, he makes a certain noise. And so we have learned to discern what that is.
Yes.
But now they can't speak. They can't tell you I'm uncomfortable. They can't tell you I'm sick. They can't tell you I'm in pain. They can't tell you that I want mommy. So what do? They cry, and God knows. I'm sorry, and the parent is able to discern. Now, what about us? Psalm 116, verse 1 and 2. I love this. I love this. I love this. Psalm 116 verses 1 and 2. And we're going to look at this in the NIV. And David makes a comment, and David found some things out about the Lord. And he says, I love the Lord. Say that. Say, I love the Lord.
I love the Lord.
Yes, for he heard my voice. Look at that now. He heard my voice. He heard, watch, look at that word, my cry.
Yes,
yes. God will hear your cry. He heard my cry for mercy. Because he turned to me, he turned his ear to me, because he turned his ear to me, I will call on him as long as I live. See, because he turned his ear to me, I will call upon him as long as I live. I want you to know there are times that you call on somebody, you go to somebody, because why? Because they're dependable.
Yes, yes.
They're dependable. Huh? And so, is God dependable? Has God been dependable to you? Has God always came through for you? Has God never let you down? You know, it's so amazing. There are certain things we can say about God. We can say never. Like, he has never lost a case. He has never lost a patient. He has never lost. He keeps his promises.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, the Bible says that he keeps his promises to 1,000 generations.
Yeah.
He keeps his promises. Oh, man. Our God is a keeper. He is a promise keeper. Amen?
Yes. Amen.
So just as we learn to interpret our cries and we respond accordingly, God does the same thing with us. Not only can he interpret our cries, but he remembers and answers them. Oh, I remember when my child cried about this. I remember when my child cried about that. I remember when my child cried about such and such. But just as mommy get up to make the milk and put the formula in the water and make the bottle at the right temperature, God is doing the same thing. God find a way to put the circumstances together so that he shows up. My Bible says that when he shows up, he don't show up empty-handed, y'all.
That's right.
He don't show up empty-handed. But here's the interesting thing. God can distinguish your cry from everybody else's cry in the world.
Amen.
A mom walks in the room, there's four children crying. Mommy knows which one is her baby. Mommy knows is her baby crying. Isn't it that way with God?
My God.
God knows, yes, if you're crying. God knows.
Yes.
And there's just something about your child that connects you with their cry. When they cry, you just can't go about doing things that you normally would do. But you come to them. When they cry, that cry gets your attention. What about God? Family, your cry get God's attention.
Yes, it does.
Yes.
Your cry, it gets up to God's attention. Just as you get up to go and pick up your child, just as you get up to change your child, just as you get up to attend to your child, your cry causes God to attend to you. And he answers your call.
Yes.
And that's why David says, I love the Lord.
Yes.
Can you say that? Say, I love the Lord.
I love the Lord.
I love the Lord.
I love the Lord.
I love the Lord because he has heard my cry. Now, I want to just tell you this morning before I get into my text. I want you to know, who are you crying out to?
Yeah.
Come on now.
I want you to know, who are you crying out to?
Come on now.
And in Exodus, the 33rd chapter, in the 18th verse, Moses, the Bible records this exchange between Moses and God. And Moses says, God, please, show me your glory. In the King James, it says, I beseech thee.
Yes.
He says, please, God, show me your glory. And so God is like, Moses, that's my boy. I've allowed him to see me, in the burning bush. I've allowed him to hear my voice. I've allowed him to enter into my glory. Because when God came down on Mount Sinai, David got a chance to enter into that glory. And so God tells him, God says in verse 20, but see, David, you can't see my face. And no man can see my face
No man can see me and live. No man. Isn't that amazing?
Yes.
But then he tells him this. He tells him in verse 20. This is Exodus 33, verse 20. He says, and it shall come to pass. You know when it says it shall come to pass? That means I got a plan.
Yes.
I have a plan. Now watch this now. He says, God, show me your faith. And God says, I got a plan. You tell God, God, I need a job. And God says, I got a plan.
Yes.
You says, God, I can't take it no more. And God says, I got a plan.
Yes.
You tell God, God, I'm a I don't know where to go.
Come on now.
God says, I got a plan. I need a promotion. God says, I have a plan. And it shall come to pass. Amen?
Amen.
If God says, and it shall come to pass, watch this now. It's that word shall. And it shall come to pass.
Yes.
And it shall come to pass. Our God that makes something out of nothing. Our God that when I see, things happen when I see. He says, and it shall come to pass.
Yes.
Yes.
That while my glory passed by.
Yes.
That Moses, what I'm going to do with you, and I'm going to put you on the cleft of a rock. You know, there is a spot where there's like this canyon and this mountain, and I'm gonna put you in the cleft of a rock. And I'm gonna cover you with my hand, and as I pass by, and once I've passed you, then you can get a chance to see
my God.
To see my back.
That's it.
And now I want you to hear this, and I remember watching some of the old Ali fights with my dad, some of the old George Frazier fights and in boxing when the fighter's being introduced, and they said, you know, and here's the fighter, and he's just standing there, and you know, he's warming up and he's trying to get in his zone, and all of a sudden he gets introduced, and the introduction in this corner, weighing in at 175 pounds, and then they can go on to give the statistics.
Right.
How many wins, how many losses, and so on and so forth. But in Exodus 34, verse 5, those of you that got a Bible, you got to open this up. I'm going to give you a minute to find it. Exodus 34, verse 5. And God is so bad.
Oh, come on.
So now, you all, we serve a huge God.
Yes.
We serve a big God. And it says that, and the Lord descended in the cloud.
Yes.
Come on now.
And the Lord descended.
Yes.
In the cloud, he had to come down, y'all, to get on a cloud. Y'all hear me?
Come on now, my God.
On a cloud and stood with them there. Now watch this now, and proclaimed the name of the Lord. Say, proclaim the name of the Lord. And watch what he says. He says in verse six. I want you to see this. And the Lord passed by him and proclaimed. Watch this now. The Lord passed by him. The Lord is passing by. And the Lord, he is so bad, y'all. He is so bad. It's like his statistics. He's about to come on the scene and he says, the Lord.
Yeah.
Yes.
But see, he just can't say the Lord. He says, the Lord God.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm just not the Lord. I'm the Lord God.
Yes.
Yes.
And watch my attributes. Watch my statistics.
Come on now.
I'm merciful.
Yes.
I'm gracious.
Yes.
I'm long-suffering.
Yes.
I'm abundant in goodness.
Yes.
Oh, you serve a good God.
Yes.
You serve a good God.
Yes.
Say, I serve a good God.
I serve a good God.
You serve a good God.
Yes.
Abundant in goodness.
And truth. Yes.
Amen. Abundance in goodness and truth. And he goes on with his statistics. Keeping mercy.
Yes.
For thousands.
Yes.
Forgiving iniquity.
Yes.
You think that God can't forgive?
That thing that you did
10 years ago?
Yes.
That you've been living with, that you've been replaying?
Yes.
It was a mistake, and God sees it as it's just as that. Do you know that God don't see you the way you see yourself?
That's right.
See, when we see ourselves as mistakes. We see ourselves in our condition. We see ourselves and based on the labels, the way that people has placed upon us.
Yes.
But I want you to know something. As this thing, as God was introducing himself, he could have started off by saying, the Lord, that I'm the Almighty, and I'm the this, and I'm everywhere at all places, and I'm this, and I'm that. But he didn't. He started off with saying, merciful.
Merciful.
Yes.
Yes.
I'm a merciful God.
Yes.
Yes.
He goes on to even reiterate it.
keeping
mercy
for thousands.
For thousands.
My God.
That includes you.
Yes.
You're in that number.
Yes.
Point to yourself and say, I'm in that number.
I'm in that number.
Oh, yeah. He has mercy for you.
Yes.
So Psalms 116, verse 1, as David was talking, and David says that not only does God hear our voice, but also our cry for mercy. And we just got through finding out that he preserves. He keeps. You know, like in his back pocket. You know, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Sometimes when y'all know that your dad always has a little bit of money, and you can go to dad and say, hey, dad, you know, can I get a 10? And you can go to God because he keeps mercy.
Yes.
And he got mercy for you.
Yes.
So I have two types of cries this morning I want to talk about. We read a book here at New Life in the City. And the book was Prayer in Another Dimension. And the author says that our prayers to God has to be vocal and fervent. Our prayers have to be vocal and fervent.
Yes.
We live in a time when our leaders they have to say things to be politically correct. You know, it's one thing for us to say that in God we trust. But then next we say, let's pause for a moment of silent meditation. Man, it ain't no silent meditation. We gonna pause for a moment of prayer.
That's it.
A moment of prayer.
Yes.
So there are two types of cries. Number one, the consistent cry. Number two, the persistent cry.
Yes.
So I said the consistent cry and the persistent cry. I want to hit the first one first. Amen. The consistent cry. The Old Testament book of Exodus opens up with God's people, God's people, the children of Israel, being in slavery in Egypt. This is in Exodus 1. And the Egyptians were hard taskmasters. They were brutal. For 400 years, God's people cried out to God, cried out to God. And in Exodus, the second chapter, the 23rd and 24th verse, it reads, years passed, and the king of Egypt died, but the Israelites continued to groan under their burden of slavery. They had been groaning. They had been crying out. They had been crying out. And it reads, they cried out for help, and their cry rose up to God.
Wow.
Some of you all that's been crying out for help, your cry will rise up before God.
Yes.
The next verse, verse 24, says, God heard their groaning, and he remembered his covenant promise to Abraham, to Isaac, and Jacob. So not only did they cry, but they groaned. And groaning, the other day my daughter asked me, she said, Daddy, what does groaning mean? And groaning means an unyielding and persistent cry, an unyielding and persistent cry.
Yeah.
You know, almost like a woman that's in travail and she's groaning. Hmm? They cry day after day, week after week, and year after year. They never stop crying for deliverance. God, for deliverance. Cries are connected to an intense desire for something.
Yes.
I'm going to say that one more time. Your cries are connected to an intense desire for something.
Right.
And they continue to cry out until their cries met up with God's set time. Say, God's set time.
Set time.
See, God has a set time for your healing. God has a set time for your marriage. God has a set time for your deliverance. God has a set time for your promotion. God has a set time. A set time. We need to constantly and continually cry out to God until that cry meets, intersects, connects with this set time. There are moments in our lives that when the will of God and our desire come together.
Yeah.
Now, one of the smartest men that lived back in the 19th century, Albert Einstein, he made a comment. He said, a coincidence is a small miracle when God chooses to remain anonymous. Wow. But watch this now. Watch this. Y'all notice what he did?
Yes.
He gave God the glory.
Yes.
I don't know how it happened.
Yeah.
I don't know how it happened, but all I know is that it's a miracle.
It's a miracle.
Notice he called it a miracle.
A miracle.
Yes. So he says, a coincidence is a small miracle when God chooses to remain anonymous. Amen? But there are times when God wants to get the glory. Say, he wants to get the glory.
He wants to get the glory.
There are times when God wants to get the glory.
Yes.
And he wants to get the glory because he wants to bless you. He wants to bless you. He wants to heal you. He wants to deliver you. He wants to carry you. There are times when he defended you.
Yeah.
When he protected you, when he cared for you, he wants the glory. Huh? When he blessed you, he wants the glory. When he healed you, he wants the glory. When he preserved you, he wants the glory.
Yes.
He wants you to know it was him. It was nobody. Huh? You ever been sick and all of a sudden you prayed, or somebody prayed for you, and all of a sudden you just started getting better?
Yes.
Huh? It wasn't a medication. It was the power of God.
That's right.
But God did it in such a way that he wanted you to know that it was him.
That's right.
That it was him. And you know what that does? That increases your faith, that increases your reliance upon him. Mm-hmm. Just like mommy. The baby knows that mommy's gonna come. So the baby cry out because mommy's gonna come.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. When I look back over my life, I see many things where I should have died. Accidents that I had. I got electrocuted, but I didn't die.
Yes.
Mm?
My God.
I fell off of a moving truck, but I didn't die.
That's right.
I've had countless accidents, and some of you all also, that's your testimony also. You may have had countless accidents where you walk out a chance to walk away from it.
Right.
May have been a near miss, or might have been a bad crash, but the grace of God. But by the grace of God,
yes.
You are alive today.
Amen.
You are alive today. So God has a set time. Say set time.
Set time.
For your breakthroughs. God has a set time for your deliverance. God has a set time. Amen. And listen to this now. The cry may have started. The cry may have started with your parents. The cry may have started with your grandparents. And you don't know who it started with, but don't stop crying.
That's right.
Don't stop crying.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Never miss the moment when never you never know that moment when your cry will intersect with God's will.
That's
say the
it.
Will of God.
The will of God.
Oh yeah, the will of God. I need to move on to the next one. The persistent cry. The persistent cry. And to see an example of this, a witness of this, in Luke, the 18th chapter. The Luke 18:1 tells us of a persistent widow, and some of you all may have known this. This is a story of a widow that was dealing with a king that was unjust. Luke 18 verse 1, and I'm going to read from the King James. It says, "And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought to always pray and not faint."
That's it.
But I want to read that in the NIV. I think you'll get a better understanding in the NIV. It says, "Then Jesus told his disciples a parable to show them that they should always pray and not give up." There are times that you have to pray and not give up. We're talking about a persistent cry.
Yes.
Pray and not
give up.
Amen. And so. This is an interesting scenario because a lot of times Jesus lays out the story, Jesus lays out the parable, and then at the end, he tells them what it means. But before Jesus even tells them what it means, he gives it away and he tells them, "I'm going to tell you this parable and the meaning of this parable because he wants it plain before us."
Yes.
Listen, y'all. We're dealing with the coronavirus, right?
Yes.
God wants it plain. God wants it plain to you so that you would know, that you would know, that you would
come
know.
On now.
That you would know, that you would know. So you don't have to interpret it. It don't have to fall. The revelation don't have to fall upon you. And no, he said it in his word. Jesus said it. I want you to know that you should always pray and never give up.
Yes.
Or however you want to say it. Pray and faint not, however you want to say it.
Yes.
But watch this now. I want you to hear the voice, the words of the Lord. In verse 2 it reads, he said, in a certain town there was a judge who neither feared God nor cared what people thought.
Yes.
And there was a widow in that town who kept coming to him with the plea, grant me justice against my adversary. Verse 4. For some time he refused. Watch this now. For some time he refused. Let's watch this now. For some time he refused, but finally said to himself, even though I don't fear God or even think or even care what people think,
that's right,
yet because this widow keeps
yes.
bothering me,
yes.
I will see that she gets justice. So that she won't, eventually keep coming back. God is an amazing God. God will bless you. God will bless you not so that you won't keep coming back, but God will bless you because of your persistent cry. Amen.
Yes.
God
amen. Will
bless, and I believe that. I believe that because of your persistent cry. I told you all earlier that we read the book Prayer in Another Dimension. And a pastor from Ghana is quoted as saying the following, because over there it's noticed that in some countries where they may not be as advanced as we are, they may not have doctors and modern medicine and so on and so forth, their prayers, their faith are at a whole nother level. And this pastor from Ghana, and he says, we pray to survive. We pray to protect ourselves from the shaman and the witch doctor. We pray and receive healing from God because there are no hospitals or doctors.
Ooh,
prayer has never been an option. It is our lifestyle.
Yes.
Is prayer an option for you?
Mama.
Huh? Is prayer an option for you?
My God.
Amen. Is prayer an option for you? There's another statement in the book that's made by Duncan Williams as he addressed a church, as a matter of fact, an American church. And he said, and just look at me and hear this, it's a long quote, but you gotta hear it. He says, if the church doesn't rise up to pray, the enemy will take over.
That's it.
The devil wants to kill you. If you pray, you will become unkillable and undiable. The more time spend with God, the less time you spend with devil problems.
Come on now. Wow.
It says, make up your mind to push as a woman in travail. It's too dangerous. Watch this now. It's too dangerous to stop praying.
That's right.
Cover your family by the blood. Cover
yes.
them by the blood.
Yes.
I gave my congregation an instruction, and I said, hey, go home and anoint your homes. And if you haven't done it, please do it today. Do it today. Our numbers in Miami-Dade County have exceeded that of Broward.
Yeah.
Do it today.
That's it.
Take the opportunity. Heal your, pray over your house. Anoint your house.
Yes.
But can we trust God to protect us? Do you believe that there's power in the blood?
That's it.
I want to share with you one last scripture, and this scripture is probably one of my most favorite scriptures. This is one that I've worn out in my Christian walk, and it's Psalm 57, verse 2. Psalm 57, verse 2 says, I will cry out to God Most High.
Yes.
To God who performs all things for me. Not some things, all things. Huh? God has healed my marriage. God has healed my body. God has healed my wife. God has healed my children. God has done so much for us. He performs all things for me. And he can perform things for you.
Yes.
He can perform things for you. I want you to see this in the proper context. And it's Psalm 57, verses 1 and 2. And you're going to see why he says that I will cry out unto God. David makes a comment and he says, "Be merciful to me, O God." And now remember now, what we saw earlier when he was introducing himself, when you heard the tail of the tape, the first thing you heard was what? He's merciful, right? Yes. He's a God of mercy.
Yes.
So he says, "Be merciful to me, O God.
Yes.
Be merciful to me, for my soul trusts in you. And in the shade, the shadow of your wings." Oh, Lord. Oh, look at that. In the shadow. Huh? Psalm 91. He that dwells.
Yes.
He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High, huh, shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Yes.
And let me go back to this. And it says, "And in the shadow of your wings, I will make
my refuge.
Until these calamities have passed by."
Yes.
Until these calamities have passed by.
Yes.
Until the Corona 19 virus have passed by.
Yes.
Until it have passed by.
Yes.
Because it has to come to pass, you all.
Yes.
It came that it might come to pass.
Yes.
Say that one more time. It came that it might come to pass. Let us pray. Father God, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we thank you. We praise you. Bless your holy name. We thank you right now, Lord God. Oh God, as your people are depending on you, Lord God. Father God, we are encouraged this morning to cry out to you, because you are the God that's able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can ask. This morning, oh God, there's somebody out there that don't know you. That there's somebody out there that's concerned. There's somebody out there that the Lord God that needs to hear your voice. And so, Lord God, we thank you today, Lord God, that not only do you hear our cry, but you will answer our call. You will turn around, Lord God, from whatever you're doing, Lord God, to come to us, Lord God.
Yes.
So, Father God, we speak your protection. This morning, if you don't know God, we want to tell you that when you come to God and when you decide that you want to lay it all before the Lord, God gives you his salvation package. That thing called salvation, it includes safety, it includes soundness, it includes preservation, it includes healing, it includes deliverance. I'm going to start off one more time. Safety, you want safety. Safety.
Yes.
Yes.
Get saved.
Yes.
Come to God.
Yes.
Get saved.
Bye-bye.
Romans 10:9, it says that if you confess the Lord Jesus with your mouth and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, that you can be saved. It's that easy. It's that easy. So this morning I want to just invite you to say that simple prayer. I want you to invite you to just say a simple prayer with me. Say, "Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus,
I invite you in my heart.
I invite you
to be Lord over my life.
To be Lord of
I believe.
I believe
that you rose Jesus.
That you rose Jesus
from the dead.
From the dead.
And today.
And today.
He is on the throne.
He is on the throne.
I invite him.
I invite
into my heart.
Into my heart.
I believe.
I believe.
And I know.
And I know
that I am saved.
That I am saved.
I thank you, Lord.
I thank you,
in
Lord.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
And you prayed that prayer, you just got saved, and I encourage you to just continue to have an experience with God. Call on the name of the Lord. Those of you all, I just encourage you all regarding prayer. I want you to know that God hears your prayer.
Yes.
God hears your prayer. Amen?
Amen.
So if you have need for prayer for anything, you can pray over yourself. God bless you. I want to just invite my wife, my lovely wife, Pastor Shaquilla, to come out with closing remarks. God bless you.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. The Bible says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name." Amen. Were you blessed today?
Amen.
I believe you were. I know I was. And I thank God for his word. Amen. Even during a time like this, I thank God for a timely word that encourages us. And it ministers to our soul. Amen?
Amen.
And we need that. Amen. So I just bless the Lord for his presence and being among us. Amen. So what we want to do is we want to get ready to worship God in a different way.
Amen.
Amen. And that is in our giving. This is also very, very important. It is a time to worship. and to exercise your trust in God and your faith in Him. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. I want to just inform you or to let you know that if your tithe belongs to the house that you are connected to. Amen?
Amen.
But the tithe for our New Life in the City members, right here, because I believe that this is good ground. This is where you want to tithe. But I do want to tell you, if you're not a member here, that you definitely have an opportunity to sow into our ministry. Amen?
Amen.
We would appreciate it. And I just want you to know, if you would like to sow via PayPal, you can do paypal.me/NLTC. Amen?
Amen.
Again, that's paypal.me/NLTC. Now, those of you that have the Cash App on your phone, you can also give via Cash App, and that is the $ New Life in the City, all lowercase, no spaces. Amen? Amen. Amen. So we just want to bless the Lord. You can also give at Zelle. That's something that we just instituted, Z-E-L-L-E. Some of you all may be more familiar with Zelle. And you can do that by way of NLTC Ministry. NLTC Ministry. Amen. We just thank God for you. And we invite you to continue to come along with us to praise and worship God with us. The word was amazing. I don't know about you, but the word was amazing. Amen.
Yes.
And I thank God that that was a rich and a right word. Amen. So you want to sow into that word. Amen. I don't know about you, but I'm believing God for blessing. I'm believing God for healing, not just for me and my family, but for your family too. We're believing God for a change in the nation, a healing in the nation, and that we will turn our faces to Him. Amen. And begin to seek His face. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So we know God is a great God. Amen.
Amen.
He's a good God. He's a great Father. Amen. He is a good, good Father. So we can soak into what He is doing. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We just give you the opportunity to give. We give you some time to go ahead and do that. Give you an opportunity. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Why are you all so preparing that? We just want to give you some announcements. We want to remind you about our Tuesday night Bible study. We've had our first and second session on a Tuesday night, and we do it, Pastor and I, we do it in our home, and we will continue doing that until further notice. It doesn't stop. The word don't stop. Amen. The word doesn't stop. So once again, this Tuesday at 7:30 p.m., we'll be ministering at home. And we're going to continue. Some of you may know that we're doing the book study on William McDowell, It's Happening. And we're having a great time. We're learning about revival. So you may say, revival during this time? Oh, yes. Oh, yes, revival. God can give us an outpouring of His Spirit even during this time. Amen. But we must be in position. We must have a longing and a desire to bring His presence. Amen. Amen. That's why it's so important that in this time that we turn and begin to seek His face and to cry out to Him. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We see God. Come back and join us on Tuesday, 7:30. At our Bible study. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Were you blessed today?
Amen.
You were blessed? Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Thank you. Thank you once again. And I also want to let you know the Zelle account we have too. And it's also, just to let you know, they're letting me know, it's NLTC Ministries at ATT.net. Okay. Once again, that is NLTC Ministries. At ATT.net. You can also give through that. This is something new that we are doing. So please, you do have that privilege or opportunity to give during, you know, with Zelle. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We're going to trust that everybody was obedient and they gave their tithe, they sold. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And we're going to go ahead and end. And you know how we do it, New Life in the City. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6.
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path.
Now turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor,
neighbor,
we had church today.
We had church
and
today.
And I was blessed.
And I was blessed.
Were you?
Were you?
Amen. 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 God bless you. I'll see you on Tuesday at 7:30. Be blessed.